3 weeks after the Munich air crash, with 23 lives lost and some of the injured still in hospital in Germany. A telephone rang in Bishop Auckland. The call was from Manchester, from Jimmy Murphy, Matt Busby's assistant. The man picking up was Bob Hardisty, who was asked if he could join Manchester United. Given that Hardisty was nearly 37 and had retired from playing 9 months earlier, he may have been forgiven for thinking Murphy had got the wrong number. But Murphy, and Busby, knew Hardisty well. They were not asking a boy to do a man's job, they were asking a man to shepherd boys. Hardisty plays again to aid United was the back page headline in the Northern Echo on February 28, 1958. Hardisty telling the paper, "Even though I'm not as fit as I'd like to be, I felt I could not refuse. I never realized how badly hit United were until Jimmy Murphy contacted me. He is with United's FA Cup team in Blackpool but was worrying over how he could fulfill the Central League fixture. The Central League players have been drafted into the first team, and it is asking too much to push schoolboys into the reserves." Hardisty told Murphy he was far from fit. Murphy replied, "I want you even if you just stand on the field and tell the youngsters what to do." Britain was in the grip of a big freeze and Hardisty said to test himself he ran across the local cricket field in 3 feet of snow. Murphy, Busby and Hardisty knew each other from the Second World War, when Hardisty had been in the RAF Scottish Command and guested for Hibs. When Busby and Murphy were in charge of the Great Britain team at the 1948 Olympics in London, they chose Hardisty as captain. He scored against the Dutch, got the winner against France and scored again in the third-place playoff against Denmark. Hardisty travelled to Manchester and had two younger Bishop Auckland colleagues with him, Warren Bradley and Derek Lewin. Like Hardisty, Bradley and Lewin were fine players. Bradley had been with Bolton, Lewin had played for Oldham. Matt Busby was still fighting for his life in Germany at the time. Hardisty, who died in 1986, recalled on the 25th anniversary of the crash. "Jimmy Murphy did a great job for him. I played a number of second-team games from February to April that season. There were so many bairns in the team and we were all carried along on a tide of emotion. Astonishingly, the first team went on to qualify for Wembley, only to lose to Bolton." Hardisty's words came under the headline, "The Busby Babe Who Began at 37. Hardisty and Lewin, now 87 and living in Lancashire, stayed with United's reserves, but Bradley's career trajectory changed. A 24-year-old teacher from Hyde, who joined Bishop Auckland after studying at Durham University. Bradley was so impressive at Old Trafford that he was signed as a semi-professional, scoring 12 times the following season, 1958-59. It was a good tally for a 5'5" and winger who was still teaching. In the wake of the disaster, United finished 9th in the league and reached the 1958 FA Cup final, where they lost to Bolton. A year later, United came second to Wolves in the league. Bradley was picked 3 times for England, the full senior team, in 1958-59. Having already appeared for England amateurs, he is still the only man to have done that in the same season. In the space of 15 months he went from playing for Bishop Auckland in the Northern League to making an England debut at Wembley against Italy. It was a 2-2 draw and Bobby Charlton scored, as did Bradley. He stayed with United until 1962 and, after a spell with Barry, became a headmaster in Bolton. He died in 2007, the month before United gave Bishop Auckland their floodlights as a thank you for the loan of himself.